What's up guys, Selag's back with a little bit of an account update. So our fishing on our skiller is at 72, cooking's at 42. And we've got 68 wood cutting on Selag, 65 magic, and 60 all round combat stats. So, going pretty well. But this video is going to be the beginning of our free to play to bond. Now the plan here is to play this account, earn a bond. It's just finished Tutorial Island, as you see, it's not a member. Selag Solo's his name, so I suppose let's get into the video. Okay, so the first thing I like to do is run up to the top of the Lumbridge Castle, just where you spawn, and run up and bank all our stuff apart from our pot and our bucket. And that's going to be so we're able to do the Cook's Assistant quest. Now you can pick up the quest right here from the cook located in the kitchens, but go collect the stuff at the same time as well, so we'll go do that, and then we'll be back. Okay, so to get these quests done, the easiest way to do it is, here's your Lumbridge Castle, where we just came from after banking, so you run out of Lumbridge Castle, heading west. And if you run north, follow up in the path, if I can move the map, there we go. You just follow the path, and it will take you to chicken pens located here, where you can grab an egg. Dairy cows here, where you can collect your milk in your bucket. I need to pick some wheat from the field here, head to the top of the windmill, put it in the hopper, pull the lever, and climb back down. So I'll come back to you when we've got that done. So one thing I thought of, just to show, just in case there's any new players watching, all you do here is you use your grain on the hole here, which is the hopper. You pop it in, you can hear it sliding down on your sounds, and your hopper controls are right here, and my voice has just went funny. Give me a sec. So what we're going to do is we're going to climb down all the way to the bottom and click empty flower bin, and you'll have a pot of flour. Okay, so I've collected the flour, the milk and the egg, but before we go back and return these all to the chef, we're going to go and we're going to do the sheep shearer quest. Now the reason that we're doing these quests off the very start is for reasons with the Grand Exchange. Now the Grand Exchange, which is located in Varrock, which is right here, so it's to the very north of where we are right now. So you just have to follow that path there, up past the Dark Wizards, and it's located just there. But it only lets you sell and trade a certain amount of items and a certain amount of things with 7 quest points. It's stopped bots from going and farming, I don't know, cow hides and bones and things like that. But that's the kind of stuff we're going to be making our money off of, so we need to get these quests done. They do grant XP, so that's always a good thing. So located on this table, inside here, next to Fred the Farmer, you'll get the quest off of Fred, and he's got a set of shears that sit on this table. I've already picked them up. But hey, we'll just get this quest done. Okay, so once you get the quest, you want to hop over the still here, into the field with the rams and the sheep in it. Now, when you do this, you don't want to click on the rams, you're going to combat, which is just waste time. So there we go, we shear a sheep and you'll get, well, we now need 20 of these. So we'll get the 20 and we'll be back. Okay, so we have collected our pot of flour, our milk, our egg. We don't need the shears anymore, so we can drop them. And we have nearly a full inventory of, I think I've actually got too many. We've got a full inventory of wool. So what you want to do is follow the path back to Lumbridge and head to the castle. Okay, so now that we're back at the Lumbridge Castle where we started, we're going to go speak to the chef and hand him the quest. Okay, so after giving him your egg, your flour and your milk, you have completed Cook's Assistant, so you get 1 quest point towards the 7 that you need to use the Grand Exchange properly, and 300 cooking XP, which takes you from level 1 to level 4, and then we'll go up and we'll spin the wheel. So you want to climb up the stairs, just located to the south, and there's a room here with a spinning wheel. Now you go in, click on the spinning wheel and spin, and you're wanting to create balls of wool, you need to make 20 here. They're not worth anything, you're only getting 3 experience points a piece, which isn't too good. But they're worth 43 coins each, but hey ho, we're not actually going to sell them, we're just going to give them to our friend, Fred the Farmer. Okay, so we'll return to Fred the Farmer, and he's given us 1 quest point, 150 crafting XP, and 60 GP, which is pretty good. So we've got 2 quest points out of the 7 that we need, 1 more quest, and we should have it. Should have recorded this at the same time. We've got level 3 crafting now from doing that quest, easy peasy. Okay, so what we're going to do now is we're going to head to the cow fields, and we're going to pick up some cow hides and bones, and magical things like that. So, from Fred the Farmer, who is located right here, you're going to head west, follow the path, and then just as you get to the anvil here, the furnace, you're going to go west again, or that's east, sorry, east, we're going east, across the bridge, and next to this dairy cow sign there's a cow field, which is more populated than the other one, and hopefully we'll find ourselves some cow hides that bots are not picking up, and as we see, they're there. So I'll be back for full inventory, and I'll see you soon. Okay, so there we go, we've got a full inventory of cow hides. Now we'll check the value of that. Now, including our 60 GP, we've got 3k here. But what we're going to do is we're going to head to the south here, take the road just outside, and we're going to pay the toll of the toll gate. And we're going to tan the leather. Okay, so the gate is just here, just south of the cow field we're collecting the cow hides from. And it'll cost you 10 GP, but we can use that from the coins that we got from the sheep shearer quest. So we're here. And we just followed the path south, pay the toll at the toll gate by holding in your screen on mobile or right clicking on the gate and pressing pay toll 10 GB. And then what we're going to do is we're going to head a little bit south. Now we're going to head a little bit south, we're going to head for the tanning sign here, the tannery, which looks like a brown t-shirt, and we're going to tan the hides because they're worth a little bit more tanned than they are untanned. Okay, so what we've done is we price checked that, it was 3k for our full inventory. Now what I've done is I've made 1 hard leather and 1 normal leather. Hard leather is 3 GP per cowhide you have. Normal leather is 1 GP, and the normal leather is actually worth more than the hard leather, which is pretty good. So what we're going to do is tan all after speaking to our main boy Ellis here. And we've got a full inventory again, so what we'll do is we'll price check this, we'll see how much extra we made. 3,730, so we've made 730 GP. It's not a lot of money now, but remember we've only been playing about 5 minutes. Well, not really, probably about 20 minutes, and you know, doing pretty well with coins. So what we're going to do now is we're going to head to Varrock. To do this from here, you're just going to head north, past the mines, keeping to the west of the mine. You're going to walk through here, straight up past the testicle looking mining thing. I think I need to go to the doctor, because one's fairly elongated there, could be too stuck in there. And we're going to head up to Varrock and bank these right here before we move on to our next quest. So, we'll see you at the bank. Okay, so we've made it to the bank here in Varrock. And what we're going to do is we're just going to deposit all our items, and we're going to withdraw our bronze sword now. This is a way to train some combat levels for when we go fishing and stuff to prevent dark wizards from attacking us. So these are training dummies. Now they'll grant you XP on your attack until level 8. But after that, no more XP unfortunately, so we'll just get that done. There we go, level 8 attack. We can wield, what is it, steel now, so we can buy ourselves a steel scimitar. But yeah, that's quick XP. So what we'll do now is we're going to go to head to the centre of Varrock, which is just heading west, and we're going to get the Romeo and Juliette quest done. It's really simple, everything's around Varrock. So we'll get that done, and once I speak to Romeo, we'll get back to you. Okay, so after speaking to Romeo here, what we're going to do is we're going to head west. Now what I recommend is you keep your run energy safe, because we're going to have to run past the dark wizards to get our cadaver berry, which can be pretty dangerous, but we'll get it done. So Juliette is located to the west of Varrock Square, in this house, up the stairs, central staircase, in her pink bedroom. Okay, so we spoke to Juliette, and we're going to head back down the stairs and head back to Romeo with our love letter. Pretty cool if you can read the letter, but unfortunately you can't. But we'll go back to Romeo. Okay, so we just finished speaking to Romeo, and he wants us to speak to Father Lawrence. Now, Father Lawrence is located in the church here next to the rear tree sign, and next to the altar sign. So he's in there, so we'll head the other way. Okay, so we spoke to Father Lawrence, and now we've got to go find the cadaver berries. Now, the cadaver berries are located next to our testicle mine here, and in one of the bushes, just north of the mine, well, a little bit northwest. So we'll head the other way, and we'll get the berry. Okay, so here at the cadaver bush, we're just going to right click, pick, or hold it down and pick a berry. Sometimes you fail and you prick your fingers on it, but we got the berry. And now what we've got to do is we've got to head west. Now if we head west, we're going to be going past the dark wizards, so keep some run energy. I forgot to run past the dark wizards. You're going to head north and you're going to head for this potion sign of the apothecary. So we'll see you there. Okay, now when you come and talk to the apothecary, you need to talk to him and talk about something else, and then Romeo and Juliet. I've done it about 5 times here and I couldn't figure out why he would only make me strength potions and stuff, but that's how you do it. So he's got everything for you. The only thing he doesn't have is the cadaver berry. So poof, there we go. That's what we have. So what we're going to do is head back to Romeo now. So we'll see you there. Okay, now once you speak to Romeo, which I actually don't think you need to do, we're going to head back to Juliet. So we'll see you there. But I had to record this, but I just thought it was pretty funny. So you're going to give Juliet a cadaver potion. Sorry if you hear my keyboard clicking, mechanical keyboard, what can you do? So we're giving Juliet the potion and we're out in the balcony here. Standing with her cousin, bottoms up, she drinks the potion, arc, and she dies. So here comes the funny bit. So Juliet has been dead 5 minutes, not even 5 minutes, 10 seconds she's been dead. Here comes our dad. Oh my poor daughter, what has become of you? Straight away, let's make preparations for her to be put in the crypt. Straight away, no mourning, nothing, just let's just shove her in the crypt. So what we need to do now is return to Romeo. So let's go. Okay, so once we speak to Romeo, we're going to go down into the crypt and we're going to save Juliet. Well, not save her, but you know, Juliet died, but we're going to complete the quest. So there we go. Romeo and Juliet quest complete, 5 quest points, and we've accumulated 7 quest points now. Doesn't take very long. We've managed to get ourselves 8 attack, 4 cooking, 3 crafting. So we can go into the Grand Exchange now and sell off our hides.